Greetings, party people. Chris from Chris Country with you. How are you today? It's been a little bit, a couple of weeks, I think, since I posted a video for you. In case you haven't noticed in the title, I'm going to show you how to bleed, or what other people call burping, a cooling system. Bleeding or burping a cooling system, the main function is just to go ahead and get air out of the cooling system. Air in the cooling system can cause a number of weird issues. Heat, no heat, back to heat again, out of your heater, blower, motor. You can have overheating issues with the engine. You could have just a weird myriad of issues. The main thing is, especially in modern vehicles, a lot of the functions from the PCM and the HVAC rely on a correct and consistent temperature reading coming off of the cooling sensor. However, if you've got air in the cooling system, that if they throw that particular sensor off, it'll throw your heater core's heat off, obviously, and things like that. Air can get into the cooling system in a couple of ways. It can be introduced via a leak in the cooling system, mainly like if you got a hole in the radiator, hole in the hose, that sort of thing. The biggest way to get air in the cooling system is anytime you open it up to do a repair. And by opening it up, I mean like thermostat change, water pump, radiator replacement, things like that. So anytime you do a repair or swap out a part in the cooling system, it's always a good idea to bleed or burp the cooling system, which I will go through and get for you. I really haven't done anything to my cooling system, but I have noticed that my fuel burn is a little less than what it should be. So part of my efforts to get this iron out is I'm just going to go ahead and burp the cooling system, only because I really don't know if and when anything's been replaced in the cooling system, and if it has been, I'm not sure. Obviously I wouldn't know either if it's been bled, so I figure why not go ahead and bleed it. You really don't need anything in the way of parts to bleed your cooling system. Probably at most a spill-free funnel if you have one. If not, just a good catch pan. Because obviously you're probably going to wind up getting some coolant spilled overboard. And yeah, I think that's it. So I will go through and show you the steps, and hopefully we can all learn something together. Alright, viewers. First step in the repair process is, of course, just get a catch pan underneath the radiator, because you will, again, probably more than likely lose at least a little bit of coolant while you're doing this procedure. You want to start off doing this procedure with the engine completely cold, mainly because you have to take off the radiator cap. Now, if you have a car or a truck or a vehicle with an expansion tank, the procedure pretty much works the same way. But I don't, in this case, I just have the regular radiator with the overflow. So we will go ahead and I'll hand the camera off to my assistant, and we will go ahead and take off the radiator cap. Usually just press down and turn. There we go. Okay then. Looks like I do have some air in the cooling system. I appear to be a little low in coolant, gang. So we will top off the radiator. I'm just gonna fill it up almost to full, and we'll burp the system and see how it goes from there. So stay tuned. Just adding some coolant, gang. Really gonna take a whole lot to top it off, so we might be working with a air bubble. Hard to say at this point. We'll know here shortly though. Alright gang, so the next step in this is, and probably one of the more critical steps, is essentially you're gonna be starting up the vehicle and running it at about 2500 RPMs until your temperature gets up to mid-range. Now what you wanna do while you're doing this is turn the heater control all the way over to hot. And then you pretty much want like nothing on an AC control. You just kind of want your fan like at an off or on a very low speed. You don't want to turn your heat on, because if you have the fan blowing, it blows up against the heater core, which, in essence, believe it or not, it actually cools the heater core down just a smidge. And the temperature variation from the fan blowing on the heater core could actually cause an air pocket to form. So that's why you don't want to run the fan. But you do want to run the heater by selecting hot, because you want to have coolant flowing through the heater core, because usually if you have air in the system, it tends to want to get trapped in the heater core. And what you want to do is, again, you're running the engine until you get up to temperature, or at least until your cooling fans kick on. This way you know that the engine's warmed up and the coolant is actually flowing throughout the entire system, essentially pushing the air out. And while you're doing this, and this is why you're going to need the catch pan, you want to have your radiator cap off, because this is where the air will actually be escaping from. So, we'll go ahead and start it up and let it run. Of course, make sure your e-brake is on for safety reasons. Like I said, just, you know, I give it about 15-30 seconds to kind of get going, and then just start revving her. Now you want to hold this RPM, and like I said, until you get up to temperature or until the cooling fans kick on. Now you're probably, if you're inside the truck, you're probably, or outside, you'll probably see some coolant kind of bubbling up through the radiator over there. But that's kind of what you want to see, because that just basically tells you you've got air coming out of the system. As you can see, the temperature's starting to climb. I'm probably up above 130 right now. I could probably plug in my scanner and tell you exactly what the temperature is, but you have a good approximation from what the gauge is doing here. And as you can tell, we are boiling a little bit. Like I said, this is kind of what you want to see. It's just helping get the air out of the system and stuff like that. A spill-free funnel would be really recommended for this job, but like I said, you can do it without the funnel. Just, you know, be aware that it is going to be a bit messy. Well, we are just about up to temperature, and it looks like it stopped getting all bubbly up there, but I would suspect that this is because the thermostat finally opened. So according to Steph, my cooling fans are on, so we will stop. And I'll check the cooling fan operation to see how it's doing. I'm learning something too. I thought I had an electrical fan, but instead I just got the regular clutch fan. When you have these, you just basically want to run it until you're up to temperature. And like I said, when the coolant dropped off, that was an indicator to me that the thermostat opened. So at this point, you want to top off your system, and then replace your radiator cap and go ahead and shut down, and that's pretty much it for burping the cooling system. Well, party people, that will give it for the bleeding system, or bleeding of the cooling system. Just like I said, key things to remember, you want to run your engine with the radiator cap all the way up until it hits temperature, until either your cooling fans kick on or the thermostat opens. Also, make sure that your heater is, the temperature is turned to on, and you don't want to run the fan. And, again, you want to start this off with the cold engine, otherwise you're probably going to burn yourself when you, open up the radiator cap. I hope this information was helpful. I am Chris, for Chris Country. You can always feel free to visit my Facebook page, Chris Country. Or, as always, rate, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I hope you all are having a wonderful day, night, week, weekend, whatever time it happens to be, wherever you may be at, and we will see you in the next video. See you later.